Now, BBC One Scotland, there's shocking news for Eileen and the residents of Shieldinch in River City.
Found out, and he said he would expose the truth if Eileen didn't toe the line.
It's on the hard drive.
It could be nothing, or it could be everything.
Please, come outside. I just want to explain.
I've had enough of your lies.
I'm trying to tell you the truth.
What is it with you, Lindsay's? You lying scandal, are you?
Do you mind if I come in for a minute? Have we drink?
What have you done?
Have you got your library book?
Mm-hmm.
Have you got your lunchbox?
Yep.
Okay, let's get you buttoned up then before your daddy comes. You are going to have a lovely day today. Guess what? I love you.
All set?
Yeah, I'm sorry, Raymond should be here in a minute.
Oh, I know, he's usually here by now.
Yeah, I don't think we're top of his list of priorities at the moment.
Oh, he'll be here. Just you get going.
Right.
Okay, bye, darling.
See you later.
Bye.
Is it Raymond Henderson?
Afraid so. Socko's just going through everything now.
What do we know?
Called in by the neighbours. Indication is that he probably died between 9 and 11. He's got a cut nose and some bruising to his shoulder.
Fight?
Or a fall. Well, it's to be a 4 p.m, but it's looking like a hose pipe.
Some start to the day.
Tell me about it.
I saw him yesterday.
How was he?
He was up to high dough about this housing development. It wasn't making a lot of sense, but not this. I better go and tell Eileen Donaghy.
Rather you than me.
Yeah, look, I'm going to head now before she hears it from someone else.
I'll speak to Uniform, get the script.
Yeah. Find out what they've touched. See if they've compromised the scene.
Even if it's suicide?
Well, it's unexplained until suicide's confirmed, but I don't think we're looking for anyone else, do you?
No.
What are you doing here? Can I get you a cuppa?
No, thank you. It's not a social call.
Something happened? Is it my dad?
No. Your dad's fine.
Well, sounds serious.
It is.
Okay, right. Now you're starting to worry me. Oh, hang on.
Listen, I've just dropped a fare off at the new estate, and I was hearing on the radio that your mob are over Raymond's house.
Yeah, that's why I'm here. Eileen, Raymond was found dead.
What? No. No, he can't. He can't be. He's got to pick Stuart up.
Dead?
I'm afraid so. I'm really sorry.
Was it an accident?
No, there was no accident. He was found in his car in his garage. A neighbour called the police when he heard the engine running and smelled the exhaust fumes. There don't appear to be any suspicious circumstances.
Suspicious? What, wait. No, no, Raymond would...
We're keeping an open mind.
Raymond killed himself, is that what you're saying?
His death is officially being treated as unexplained.
He wouldn't, not with Stuart.
Eileen, when did you last see Raymond?
I saw him yesterday morning.
How was he?
He wanted to talk, but I didn't. I wasn't nice.
I'm really sorry, Eileen, but we'll need a formal identification of the body.
No.
We can't proceed without an identification.
What do you mean, proceed?
Post-mortem. To establish how Raymond died.
What are you doing?
Head of the dog, what's it look like?
Did I look at you? What happened last night?
I'll be fine.
Da.
Just leave it.
Where are you going?
Work. Why?
Look like that. I don't think so. You're stinking of sweat and booze. Is that blood?
Looks worse than it is.
Da, you're an absolute mess. Are we in a fight?
Don't tell your sister. I mean it. I get into a wee rammy with Raymond Henderson.
Really? What about?
Hey, I'm no proud yet. I was in the porter cab and I just lost it with him.
Hey, well, he probably got what he deserved. Did you win?
Doesn't feel like it. I'm going for a shower.
Would it have done just give him a kiss goodbye?
I just don't understand it. I mean, I was with him just a couple of days ago. I can't even take it in.
You have to remember the good things.
I don't know, even he's as strong.
I'm not.
What was that about?
Sorry?
Oh, shit. Well, they say goodbye and you stopped her.
In cases like this, I'm sorry.
I'll take you back to Shieldinch now, yeah?
I want to go to the house. To Raymond's house.
That's not really convenient at the moment. They're still working there.
I want to see the house. That's not too much to ask, is it? Such a big house. That's what he wanted for Stuart.
Had Raymond been here long?
Just a few weeks.
Have you been here before?
Yeah, once or twice. Just dropping off Stuart.
I take it there was no problem with that?
No. Things with Raymond weren't ideal. The last thing I did was argue with him. I told him it wasn't for Stuart. I didn't want him in my life.
Yeah, come on, I mean, how would you have known? I mean, we all know what he's been like recently. Look.
I didn't realise he was so obsessed.
Well, the last time I spoke to him, he just kept on raving on about it.
Is that enough to take his own life? Raymond. It's a kid's bed. Can I look in the garage?
They're still working in there.
I'll be fine.
I'm sorry, Eileen. How about?
It's dying in your car. It's not right.
Anything comes to mind, call me.
Jimmy, I need to tell my dad. And Liz. And Stuart, somehow. Will you do me a big favour? Will you talk to Stevie for me?
Of course.
I don't know why you're here, but it's perfect timing. I've just made a pot of tea.
No, I'm fine, Liz.
Oh, now Raymond never appeared, so Malcolm and I took Stuart to nursery, didn't we?
We did indeed, yeah.
Eileen? Something the matter?
You've been crying, Pe.
A bit.
Oh, come on now. Look, I'll get you a cup and we can share your problem.
Liz, you... Just sit down.
Come on. How is it, Pe?
Dad, Raymond died.
What do you mean, died?
No.
I think it was
Suicide?
No!
I've identified his body.
Oh, God, Eileen. Oh, I'm so sorry. God, he was a lovely man.
Yes.
Oh. Oh, no, that's rubbish.
What, that is the absolute truth? That's what happened.
No danger, I'm loving that. You all right?
Yeah. Jenny, could you get me a large whiskey, please? Make it two. You might need one. It's about Raymond.
Not again. You should have seen him last night. Proper own man he was, I had to chuck him out.
That's not what I meant.
What is it, Jimmy?
The police have found him in his car this morning. He's dead.
That's not even funny. He was just in here last night, in Alan's face.
I think it's suicide.
No. No, Raymond.
I know.
He said he was going to make it right.
Make what right?
Everything. I never thought we meant this. Oh, Jimmy, he was so good to me. I don't believe
it. I know, it's just hard to believe.
What? I better get to work.
Behave yourself. Come on, get a seat and just get yourself together, eh? We need to be strong for Ireland, don't we?
Aye. But I still need to work.
Last night, you came in then you went back out, right?
I did.
So when did you have this fight? Before or after?
Before. Angus, I don't want to talk about this.
Right, so where did you go after?
I can't tell you that, son.
Da.
Don't push it.
Look, I know you like the old dram, but fighting and getting on the lash first thing, that's not you. And by the way, you've really impressed Kirsty.
Just leave it, okay? I need to go to my work.
Oh, great.
We need to talk. Not now. At the porter cabin. I'll see you in a bit.
Thank you.
like. You know, I mean, seeing him.
It was unreal. But it was him. Raymond. You know, Scarlett, when I went to Ireland's office this morning, I thought something wasn't right. I never, ever thought... I need to keep an eye on her. And Stuart.
Aye, of course.
And Stevie.
Aye. Jimmy, you all right?
No, really.
I think he was trying to tell me something. I think he was trying to ask me for help.
Nah, don't even think about blaming yourself, Mon. We're going up the road. Okay.
So you both had a square go, right enough. As I hope. What was that about?
I wanted to tell him my side of things. Explain to him how I never wanted any of this. I even begged him to return the hard drive.
Is he gonna?
What do you think?
Hi, Stella. I know this is a bad time, but I just got a call from Jimmy Mullen. Could I see Stevie, please?
Well, he's not really that great, then, eh?
I appreciate that. I'll be as quick as I can.
Right, okay. He's in there.
Hi, Stevie. I understand Raymond was in the ship last night. Can you run me through what happened?
He was shouting at Alan Lindsay.
What about?
I don't know, he was just banging on about chromium cancer and all that.
Anything else?
He kept saying to Alan that he was in it for the money and treating folk badly.
Do we really need to do this, then?
Just take your time, Stevie.
Please?
It was embarrassing. I told Raymond to leave and take his mad theories with him.
And Alan Lindsay followed him?
Aye.
What time is this?
7-ish. Just after it, maybe. It's unforgivable, isn't it? After everything he's done for me, I just chucked him it. It was his pub.
You weren't it, you know.
That doesn't help.
That's enough, eh?
Of course. Thanks for your time. Shouldn't you be cleaning that up?
Aye, later.
As if things couldn't get any worse, looks like he's made a complaint.
Brilliant.
Go and see anything, see what he says.
You think I'm stupid?
Officer. Mr. McAllister, Mr. Lindsay. Handy you're both here.
Why's that?
I've got a few questions I need to ask you. Where were you last night?
In the ship.
All night?
Aye.
And after that?
Home, bed.
Can anyone back that up?
My kids.
Okay, good. And you? I was with my girlfriend, Kelly Marie, all night. What's this about?
We found the body of Raymond Henderson this morning. I'm trying to establish his last movements.
Raymond's dead?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
How did he die?
It's unexplained until we carry out a postmortem. Can't be certain of how he died.
Oh, surely he can tell us more than that. Where did it happen?
In his car. In his garage.
I don't understand why he come here.
As I say, we're just trying to piece together his final movement, so I won't keep you long. I believe you had an altercation with Mr. Henderson in the ship last night?
We had a few words, if that's what you mean.
What about? Was he part of this development?
Was. Not anymore. I bought him out.
Really? You'd be unhappy about that, I'd imagine.
Not at all. It was his idea. I was glad, I'll admit that much.
Because?
He didn't share our vision. And that made him a liability. His behaviour became erratic.
So people wanted Raymond out of the way?
No. We were trying to put distance between ourselves and Raymond, not get rid of him, or know the mafia.
I'm not suggesting you are. This is just procedure. It's necessary.
Look, a lot of people were getting fed up with Raymond, including me. He was acting like he'd lost the plot.
Well, I appreciate your candour. Look, if you think of anything, anything at all, get in touch.
No problem.
Find out you lied.
I know that. I just need some time.
You all right?
The guy I fought with, he's dead. I just lied to the police about where I was.
Right. We need to wash these. How did he die?
She don't know. Doesn't matter how he died. We fought, he's dead. Looks bad, doesn't it?
But did he not leave the porter cabin?
Aye, he was fine. I watched him drive away. He was found in his car. The police are treating it as unexplained.
Unexplained?
I'll have to go and talk to them.
No, of course you shouldn't. You stay well away, you know what they're like. It's anything for an easy life, and if they need somebody, you'll do. Look, no buts. We need to think straight.
What if I injured him and that's why he died?
Oh, come on, Di, you're hardly Mike Tyson.
I know, but...
If worst comes to the worst, we'll just need to prove it, do you not think?
Angus. What if this is my fault, if I killed him?
You just say that it was a mistake. You were defending your property.
Son, this is serious. It's a man's life we're talking about here.
Aye, and I'm talking about yours. Ours. Dad, you've got to tell me where you were.
I've already said I can't.
We've already lost Mum. We can't lose you as well.
Well, it looks like one of your problems has gone away. We left the other one in his house. The hard drive.
What are you on about?
Alan had a fight with Raymond last night.
And?
Raymond's dead. Found his body this morning.
Result? Wouldn't you say?
Is that not a bit harsh? He used to be one of our investors.
There used to be a pain in the arse. And now that pain's gone.
Alan lied to the police about being in the pub all night. Try to cover up for the fight.
You should talk to them. It wouldn't look good you lying about it. And don't worry about the hard drive. I'll sort it.
How?
Just leave it to me.
I'm sorry. I just need to be sure of something. You said last night after Raymond left the pub, Alan Lindsay followed him.
That's what I said, aye.
And this was seven-ish, absolutely sure.
7:15, 7:30.
What time did Alan come back?
He never did.
Okay. Thanks very much. I'll see myself out.
If you saw him drive away, you can't be to blame. How can you be? Who's to know what he get himself involved in after he left? He was looking for trouble, you said he was.
But people saw me leave the tall ship with him. The porter cabin's covered in his blood.
He walked away.
I know he did.
I'll get it. Stay calm. You've done nothing wrong.
Except lie to the police.
Hello. I'd like to speak to your father, if he's in.
You told us you were in the tall ship pub until closing time. We've witnesses who say you left well before that, with Raymond Henderson.
Closing? Nah, my dad came back about 8.
Angus.
Did you go out again?
No.
Anyone verify that?
Aye, me.
Does he have to be here for this?
No, not at the moment.
Da.
When you go?
Sure.
I'll talk to you later, son.
You been in a fight?
I'm a builder. Pick up cuts and bruises in my line of work.
Didn't think you'd been doing much building lately. You look fresh. The body of Raymond Henderson had bruising, an injury to the nose. You were seen in a heated debate with the deceased shortly before you followed him from the pub. You can see how that looks. You want nothing to say about that?
Understand, do you think?
Oh, yes. I think so. He's struggling with it. Quiet.
I need to tell Stuart.
Oh, yes. That would be best.
But how? How do I tell a wee boy this? His daddy's gone.
It's not right, Cass.
Malcolm. Liz.
It's really nice of you both.
It's at least we can do.
We're really sorry. I don't really know what else to say. I don't know if it helps.
It does. It does help.
I can't make any sense of it.
It doesn't make any sense. That's why. Is there anything we can do? Phone anybody or sort anything out for you? Thank you, but do you not need to get back to your work? That's the last thing in my mind, don't I? There is one thing you can do. Take a weight off my mind.
What?
Will you take Stuart for me for a wee while? I'm not ready for that yet.
Of course. I'll keep the wee man entertained. Where is he?
He's at nursery. He finishes soon. I was going to go and get him.
No, we'll go and get him.
Thank you.
Glad to.
Up the porter cabin and the steps outside. I've used so much bleach I've lost my fingerprints.
You think it looked like I killed him? That's what you're thinking, isn't it?
What I'm thinking really isn't the issue.
It is to me, son.
You're not going to jail. Hey, look, Dad. I came down late last night for a drink and you weren't on that couch. Now, I'm more than happy to clean up for you, but you need to be honest with me. Where were you? Where are you going now?
Porter cabin.
I take it we'll be getting those PM results tomorrow, yeah?
Yeah, I marked it high priority.
Just a weird conversation with that Alan Lindsay. He had an argument with Raymond Henderson in the Tall Ship pub and then followed him out. Can't account for his whereabouts after that.
What are you thinking?
I don't know. It's just odd.
You think it might not be suicide?
I'm thinking we need to find out what Lindsay was up to. Now, yesterday, Raymond was ranting on about how he thought one of the guys connected with the development had been taken out.
I did wonder if it was something else. I don't think this has anything to do with Raymond's past misdemeanors, do you?
I'm going to bring Lindsay in for questioning. Sergeant Christie, come with me.
Hey, darling. How was school?
Same old, same old. Have you been doing a bit of spring cleaning?
Something like that. I got your message, by the way. I'm sorry.
Well, you scrubbed up okay, so I'll let you off. What are you doing?
Oh, paperwork. Usual slog. I should have been long.
So I'm on dinner tonight. Thanks, Dad.
Hey, don't be cheeky. I'll be back in a bit, okay?
Dad, there's the police out in the yard.
Yes. Mr. Lindsay, we'd like you to accompany us down the station, please.
What for?
Further questioning. We're also going to get forensics to give your workplace the once over. Anything you want to tell us?
Nothing.
Okay, let's go.
Dad, what's he talking about?
It's nothing, darling. Just go home. I promise you.
Yeah, but he said further questioning.
Darling, it's just a misunderstanding.
Why are you guys taking
him? Doesn't he just go home?
I'm not going to go home. I'm not telling you anything. I don't... What? Why are you taking him away? Dad! Where are you taking him? See my dad, please. They're taking Dad away.
What for?
Questioning.
Kirsty will be fine.
No, he won't. Dad!
Kirsty.
Angus, Dad! Angus, get off me! Dad! Dad!
doing this? Why are they taking him away? What did that do?
Nothing. I'm honest.
No, I don't believe you.
And get forensics down here. Looks like somebody's been attempting a wee clean-up.
Come on. This really isn't how it looks.
You expect me to believe you?
Well, of course. Just don't get yourself wound up about nothing.
He's been arrested.
Kirsty, he's been taken in for questioning.
So why have they taken him away?
Well, it looks to them like he might have done something, but he hasn't.
How do you know that?
He told me. Somebody died. That Raymond Henderson guy, he's been hassling Dad about the development.
They think he killed somebody.
Of course not. It's just procedure.
That's it. Well, there's the first bit there.
Yeah.
Right, so we need...
the sun bit.
The sun bit. So let's have a wee... Oh, no, wait. See if you can make that work. See, that fits. See? Well done. Right, so let's see if you can find the farmer.
Found it.
Well done.
Stevie.
Back in a minute, Paul.
You okay?
Aye.
I like your tent.
Cheers. He keeps asking about Raymond.
Well, he's gone, isn't he?
I know. I can't tell him. He needs to be island.
Aye. Just you keep him occupied, then, huh?
That's what I'm doing.
Say something daft. They're good at that.
Aye.
Right, I'll go make you something to eat.
Thanks. Hey, wee man. I've had enough of that jigsaw mince. Do you want to do something else? See, I can do that better than you.
Okay, let's go back through things again, shall we? Step by step.
I told you. I went to the ship, I got talking to Raymond, he lost the heat, started shouting at me. Stevie asked him to leave.
You followed him from the bar to have it out?
No, to talk sense into him.
You both ended up in your porter cabin. Why was that?
The porter cabin is private. It's better than shouting the odds in the street.
And everything was reconciled amicably, was it? Or you lost the rag?
We both did.
Land a few punches?
I landed a punch. You could hardly call it a fight. I know how this looks. But he was very much alive when he left.
So you say? Your porter cabin is spotless.
I cleaned up.
Really? You know that even with raw bleach, you leave traces of blood behind. Those faint stains are being analysed as we speak. So we've got you on attempting to pervert the course of justice, if nothing else.
I want a lawyer.
You alright?
So stupid. Dad's not capable of killing anyone. I miss him already.
Don't talk about him as if he isn't coming back.
That's what I'm most scared of.
Me too. Look, I think that he can prove he didn't do it, but he just doesn't want to.
I don't know what you mean.
I think he was doing something else, but he didn't want to tell me what. He looked embarrassed.
Do you think he's got a girlfriend?
Dad. No. He's got us. Come on. You come to watch some telly?
No.
You know I'm here, right?
I know.
Marks on both you and the victim. Witnesses to an altercation between you both. You freely admitting a further physical altercation in your porta cabin. An attempt to conceal evidence. It's not looking good. You're looking at a very serious charge, unless you can prove where you were last night between the hours of 9 and 11. At the very least, you're looking at a night in the cells. Okay. Well, Lindsay, I'm detaining you for further questioning in relation to the death of Raymond Henderson on September the 15th, 2014.
I'd like to make a call.
About the case?
My kids. Let them know I won't be home tonight.
Okay. Interview suspended at 1942 hours.
Right, okay. No, we're fine here. Right. I'll let Kirsty know. Cool, see you then. Bye.
Is that Dad?
Yeah.
Is he coming home?
He's been kept in overnight.
Can we see him?
Not now. Tomorrow morning.
Has he got a lawyer?
Yeah. There's nothing more we can do.
Okay. Right, well, I guess that's it for tonight then. I'm gonna be upstairs.
Okay.
It's okay. They all right?
What do you think?
Alan, you need an alibi. Badly. Look, if the reason you can't tell us is because you were somewhere you shouldn't have been and you're too embarrassed, then I suggest you get over yourself. Because whatever it is you were up to, take it from me, it is not going to be half as embarrassing as facing a murder charge.
My kids can't find her.
T.I. Craig Donald recommencing interview with Alan Lindsay at 1951 hours. So, where were you last night between the hours of 9 and 11? Who were you with that you shouldn't have been?
My wife.
That's a new one?
She left us 6 months ago, went to live in Dubai. She's got an old school friend out there. living the dream if you believe the photographs, which Rona did.
So, last night?
I'd heard she was back in Glasgow for a couple of days. Something to do with visa requirements. And she called me, asked me to meet her at the guest house she's staying at. That's where I went after the fight.
Why is this a big secret?
She hasn't contacted her kids once since she left. Not once. How do you think they're going to feel when they find out she's been back in Glasgow and hasn't bothered to see them?
So you met up to have it out?
I met up to try and make her see what she's done to these kids. Try and make her see sense. Try and make her come home.
What happened?
I went and I met her in the bar in the guest house.
You got a name for the place?
It's in Polish Hills. I've got a card somewhere.
What time is this?
Back at 9.
Any witnesses?
The barman, couple of guests.
Good. How long were you there?
Half an hour, tops. She only wanted to meet me so that I could sign some paperwork, separate her bank accounts.
Okay, so you were there till about 9:30, what then?
I stayed there about 20 minutes finishing my drink. Hoping she'd change her mind and come back down to her room. Then I went to that bar on Polson Street, had a few drinks until closing.
And what?
Pizza.
Where from?
Italian next door. Then I went home.
Interview terminated at 19:54 hours. Right, get the name of this guest house, get over there, check out the CCTV, also the stuff from the bar and this pizza place, and get Mrs. Lindsay in for an interview.
Is that really necessary?
Hey, you better pray she's still there. Lock him up.
How's he been? Aye, fine. He's tired, but yeah, getting close to his bedtime. I can't thank you enough. I don't want to ask. Is he in there? Aye, on you go.
He huffs, and he puffs, and he blows your houston. But he won't blow this houston, won't he, know, because we're inside and, you know, nice and cosy.
It's lovely.
Well done, me man. Perfect.
Stevie.
He's knackered.
Stevie, I saw Alan Lindsay being taken away in a police car.
What, arrested?
Could be.
Well, I tell the police, Alan left the bar with Raymond.
What were they arguing?
Not so much Alan. He was meant to calm him down.
But they left together.
Aye. Listen, Eileen, he keeps asking about Raymond.
Can I ask another favour of you?
Aye, of course.
Can I talk to him in there? Just with my dad and listen.
No, of course you can, absolutely. Listen, we'll make ourselves scarce. Just you take your time, all right?
Thanks. Nice in here, isn't it? With all the sparkly lights and everything. Do you know what I think this is like? I think this is a wee bit like heaven, do you remember? Where angels live.
Angels live there.
They
do. Angels live in heaven, and I think they're really, really happy there. I think in here it looks a bit like heaven, and Mummy is. Mummy's just really, really sad today. Sweetheart. Daddy had an accident. And he's gone to live with the angels now. And he'll be really happy being an angel. But it means that we won't see him anymore. It's just going to be you and me from now on. Okay? Just you and me. We're going to be fine, okay? We're going to be fine. And we're just going to think about all the angels in heaven. Come here.
You ruined my professional reputation, and all the time you knew that land was bad.
Eileen has a copy of the report.
The hell did I get involved in this?
Frank Payton is promoting developments just like this one all over Glasgow.
There's nothing illegal about that.
There is.
I'm Detective Inspector Donald, Shieldinch and Musgrave Police.
What's this about?
Any murder? Friend of yours?
It's not going to be any funeral until I know how he died.
Next on BBC One Scotland, a change to the schedule with 2 days to go before Scotland decides. David Dimbleby interviews First Minister Alex Salmond and former Prime Minister Gordon Brown. And that means tonight's 30th anniversary episode of Crime Watch is now at 10:40.